ってなるから、
うん、はい、こうしどうこう。
And this is the what it left from the Victory, the chassis. As we can see, actually the chassis is pretty good. It's almost rust free. It looks pretty good in my opinion. Of course it's pretty old, that's why it's not looking clean as the Jeep. But still, for that age, it looks perfect. We're going to see what we're going to do with this chassis. Probably something stupid, as usual. But for now we're going to leave it like that. Of course we need to take the front bumper and grill to align it with the Jeep chassis. But we're going to see, this is not so important. Let's see, is the body of the Victory and the chassis of the Jeep is going to align at least a little bit. So this is how it looks. The chassis of the Jeep and the shelf of the Victory. Perfect fitment. It's going to be so easy. Or not. We can clearly see the difference. The reservoir fitting here aligns with ours. And yeah, a lot of cutting is going to be needed from the, for sure from the behind and the front. But it's not impossible. The rear fender. The alignment is close enough. This is how it looks. The interior part. The biggest play is going to be around here. There will be a lot of alignment to fit this part to the Jeep chassis. Защото е лекичка.
Чука-пука.
Защото де факто сега дойде много назад.
Още може да се излезе.
Okay, so this is the first fitment of the body and the chassis. Pretty rough, but I think little by little is going to happen. We cut it everything from inside to gain access to be able to install the instrument cluster of the Jeep. And of course the rear. You can see the height of the car right now, but of course when the engine and the gearbox is installed and all the interior, this is going to compress all the suspension and it's going to go little bit lower. But for sure this is going to be much higher car than before. It's going to be like SUV or even a Jeep. But just a quick glance how it's going to look. Of course, a lot of job before everything is attached. Right now it's just placed. Nothing is tightened with bolts. And let's continue. This is the idea what we're going to do to attach the chassis of the Jeep and the body of the Victory. We're going to use this square tubing. Yeah, we're going to weld it to the chassis of the Jeep. This is the point where we're going to weld it. As we can see, this is one of the main points. This is the other. And we're going to lay the weight of the body over this tubing.
With some L brackets.
Yes, after that we're going to use some L brackets. which we're going to attach to the chassis of the Jeep. We want to be sure that everything is going to be straight and there will be no misalignment of the two of them. So that's why we're going to use L brackets with bolts for the beginning. And after we are done with the alignment, we're going to remove the bolts and we're going to do the final welding to the chassis. So I'm going to take you through what we're going to do step by step. So this is the left side. I showed you the right side. So this is how it looks on the left side with all the weldings to the chassis. So this is the L brackets that we installed on the body, on the both sides. This is the other one, and on the other corner,
well, what?
Yes, it was here. They're going to lay on the square tubing that we welded previously on the chassis of the Jeep. As we saw, we welded the L brackets on the front, and right now they are ready on the back. As we can see, we straightened up some places, some important places on the body of the Victory. We needed to cut a little bit more on the back because we need the whole body to go a little bit further to the front because we need additional space. Yes, the fenders are right now installed, and as we can see, we're going to have a little bit problem with the alignment of the wheel. We're going to need to cut a little bit the fender from the back, as from the rear fenders. Once again, we're going to need to cut them from the back on the rear too, to fit the wheels in them. And as we can see, we need a little bit more room on the front to be able to install the two radiators, the coolant radiator and the AC radiator to their original places. As we can see, the front subframe is cutted. This is the subframe that's cutted, this piece here. It was going to be very good if we was going to be able to leave this, because this is straightening the chassis a lot, but we cannot leave this. We're going to modify this part of the chassis for sure. We're going to see how it's going to be fitted, because here we need to install the grill which we removed from the Victory, and this is the sub grill frame which we need to install once again. And for that, we need to do some modification on the front. A lot of modification for sure. We're going to see how we're going to attach the fenders to the chassis, because these fenders are really, they're enormous, and they need to be attached really good to the chassis, because they're going to move everywhere. They're right now bolted only on one side, but we need to figure out how we're going to attach them to the chassis. They should be easily removed, because you can imagine how hard it's going to be work on this engine with these big fenders here. So we need to figure out how to attach them, and once again we need to modify a little bit more here. As we can see right now, the body is lay on the chassis by itself. The lift is removed on the both sides, on the left and on the right. Right now the body is laying on the chassis of the Jeep by itself. A little bit more alignment is needed. As I told you guys, we need to cut a little bit more on the back of the chassis of the Jeep, because we need to push the whole body a little bit further. We're going to see how much we're going to cut it. Few centimeters more for sure. And step by step, we are getting somewhere. A lot of job is done, but still a lot of job ahead of us. So let's continue with the cutting, grilling and cursing and everything. Okay, we're going to continue with the rear fenders. This is the idea what we're going to do, because the alignment of the fender is not matching the rear wheel. So the thing that we're going to do is,
we're gonna cut the quarter panel.
From where? From here?
From here. And we're gonna move it to the side approximately 12 centimeters.
From this point? 12 centimeters.
Yeah. And gonna TIG weld it back to place and put some patch right there.
Patch what?
Patch.
Значи metal sheet. Yeah. And we're going to put some metal sheet here to как и да запълним.
To match the length.
To match the length of the fender. And we want to use. Не това ще бъде?
Yeah, primitive TIG welding machine.
Не, здраво съм по-оптимистично.
Yes.
Right now my colleague is in the middle of как е да се живиш the restoration of. Yeah, restoration звучи по-як. Ама как се кажеш това? Under bumper metal sheet, which is looking terrible from below, but there were some missing parts of it, and he right now is trying to fix that and restore it in the previous look when there was no rust here. Yeah, it's a big headache to restore the whole piece, so that's why we took this MIG TIG plasma torch to do the job. And we're going to see what's going to happen. I'm going to record the process of rebuilding this rear fender, and we're going to see how it's going to match the Jeep chassis. So in the middle of the work on the front fender, we are removing the wheel arch, and after that we're going to cut the fender 10 or 12 centimeters, 10 or 12 centimeters more to the back, and we're going to need to weld the wheel arch to the fender, but this time it's going to be placed here. And of course after that we're going to need to make some patch which is going to attach to the wheel arch, because we're going to end up here with empty space, because the whole fender is going to go 10 or 12 centimeters
to the back.
So we're going to see how it's going to look, and in few words we are making a whole new fender, или как да го кажа? We are making a custom fender because of the Jeep chassis. So the wheel arch is cutted out from the fender, and this is how it's going to look. As I told you, 10 or 12 centimeters to the back. Here is going to be filled with some metal, metal sheet. As I told you, it's going to be pretty much custom fender for this body. We are in the middle of fabrication of the front fender.
Restoration.
On the restoration on the front fender. This is self-made piece of the fender, which is we're going to drill a hole here, which going to hold the fender to the body. There are going to be two holes here, which is going to hold the fender to the body.
Part.
Yes, this is the original part that my colleague cut it from here, and as we can see, he made it perfectly match. This is how it looks, perfect match. And after that, he welded it to the fender itself. And it's going to hold much better than this one, this rusty kind of metal. And after that he done this, he straightened this metal piece of the fender here. Къде беше заварката? There was a lot of rust here, as here. We can see there is some metal missing here, so it's going to need some welding here to make it stronger, because when we put a bolt here or something, after a time it's going to break here, so we're going to try to do it a little bit stronger. Okay, so this fender looks much better than the other one. This one is going to take much more restoration before we install it to the body, and as we saw, we're going to have a lot of work on the wheel arch because it needs to be realigned. And yeah, all the holes for the bolts going to need some job on them, and little by little it's going to start looking like a normal fender. Everything is repaired. This is one of the fenders once again. The front grille is disassembled. Let's take a look on the front. As we can see here, once again, it looks much better than before for sure. There's going to be some repair where the fender is going to hold. And of course, there were a lot of work to restore the front grille, which is going to be attached to this lower metal sheet. And yeah, as we can see, it's really slow and painful job to be done. DIY hydraulic curve square tubing device. This is how it looks. This is how it's made. Let me film it here. So with this method we're going to curve the square tubing, which we're going to use for holding the two front fenders.
Color отбор.
And this is the end result. Perfect fitment on the fender. As you can see, like that. And like that. We're looking for the cleavage where the bolts attached to the fender itself. As you can see. So this is the end result with the mounting brackets, which are going to hold the front fender. We're going to have 5 bolts on each fender, on the top side of course. So it's going to go like that. As we can see, all the bolts lined up with the holes of the fender. And this is going to be the main support from the top of the fender. And this is how it looks when it's mounted with all the bolts, as we can see from the bottom side. So we need to figure out how to attach this to the chassis of the Jeep. We used another sheet of metal here because it was rusty as hell. I'm going to show you on the other side because this right now is painted and it's a little bit hard to see it. But let's see on the other side. So this is on the other side, which right now we are working on. And this is the how it looks from behind, how much it was rusted. Right now it's pretty good cleaned, but before that it was really rusty.